Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Meet again on the channel YouTube Senarai Cerita Gisna. This time, I will share insights on empowering women through cooking based on Cumi class. Previously, I'm Agisna Putri. I will accompany you about 5 until 10 minutes with the interesting information in this video. According to Perkins and Zimmerman, 1995, that empowerment has been defined as a deliberate ongoing process centered on the local community, which involves mutual respect, critical reflections, care, and group participation by accepting access and control. However, according to Oni Espirjono and Pranaka in Putri 2018, which states that empowerment is a process in society to become empowered, encourage or motivate individuals to have or be empowered to determine their life choices. According Guterres and Ortega 1991, in Perkins 2010, the general elements that encompass the definitions of empowerment include 1. It is a process. 2. It occurs in the community, and I would add in organizations. 3. Involves active participation. 4. Involves access to and control over decisions and important resources. So, and how about empowering women? Described in a literature review by Haryono Siono in Ruslan 2010, women's empowerment is often claimed as improving the quality of women's personal life, namely providing efforts to empower women's lives in various fields. According to Harazika 2011, empowering women means equipping women to be economically independent, to be independent, to have positive self-esteem, so that they can face difficult situations and be able to participate in development activities. Empowered women must be able to participate in the decision-making process. Empowerment activities certainly have good goals and benefits for the participants who follow them. For you who are still hesitant or confused about participating in empowerment activities, especially women's empowerment activities, let's first examine what the goals and benefits of empowerment for women are. According to Nugraha 2008, the objectives of the Women's Empowerment Program are as follows: increase the ability to get involved in development programs, 2. Improve leadership abilities, 3. Increase the ability to manage a household-scale business to open productive and independent work opportunities, and 4. Increasing the role and functions of women's organizations at the local level to become a forum for women's empowerment. While the benefits, women's empowerment provides space for women to develop their abilities and build themselves into empowered and independent women. Cooking activities are familiar activities for the public, because these activities are closely related to fulfilling nutritional intake for every human body in this world. This cooking program is used as an event for women's empowerment, which is to provide space for women who have a hobby of cooking, or provide knowledge and methods for each step to start cooking for those who still have difficulty doing cooking activities.
Cemil class is the program to make snacks. This cemil class was initiated by one of the productive housewives who have more knowledge of various recipes for making snacks. This cemil class activity includes, of course, clearly sharing recipes for making healthy and practical snacks for women, especially housewives. In this class, the dominance of the participants is housewives. They take the time to participate in this class by making a snack recipe with a deadline of 1 month to share one recipe for making snacks. Technically, it is not only the founder of this class program, but founder invites participants to share recipes together. As involved in this program, participants must report the results of their cooking by taking pictures of these results and sending them to the WhatsApp group. Other activities include sharing difficulties or failures in cooking, such as sharing knowledge about the use of good food coloring products and others. So far, I have participated in this class. The aim of which is in by empowering housewives so that they can increase knowledge about various snack recipes which will be useful for processed snacks to be served to their families. In addition, joining this class can actually provide good opportunities for housewives and women who are not married and can to be used as knowledge capital to start a business of various processed snacks. So, this is my result snacks to recipes from Chewy class. Bread, bakso tahu, putu cake, cherry pop, jelita cake. But yeah, most of the recipes are Indonesian food, also traditional food in Indonesia. So, thank you very much for watching my video.